Good afternoon, dear Forex traders.
Good afternoon. It's me, Anna Kasatkina.
And me, Olga Vitkovskaya.
This is InstaForex TV Economic News Channel.
We present a combined outlook of Forex and stock markets for the previous week. Anna, what are the last week main events on the currency market?
On Friday, the European Common Units surged to a three-month high.
What caused the upward movement?
Weak US labor market statistics that added to rumors about the forthcoming T-notes purchases by the FRS. The US dollar index ICE fell 1.1% to the mark of 80.182 points from 81.089 points fixed on Thursday. Weekly, the index lost 1.3%. At the same time, the dollar index WSJ also declined by 1.1% and decreased to the gauge of 70.02 from the notch of 70.75 points. The euro-US dollar pair strengthened to 1.281 US dollars, thus having weekly gained 1.8%. The euro is now trading above 1.28 pips since the end of May. On Friday, the US labor market informed that in August, mere 96,000 jobs were created against the planned 125,000. However, the unemployment rate fell in August from 8.3% to 8.1%, but the experts state that this is just the result of the workforce outflow. Before the reading release, the greenback was pressurized as new pack of stimulating measures by the Chinese government became the reason for increase in purchasing more risky assets, such as securities. On Thursday, the euro upped, supported by Mario Draghi's speech when he uncovered some details of the ECB plan to unlimited purchases of the eurozone obligations. In addition, the Australian dollar grew to 1.0397 pips against the greenback, having gained weekly 0.7%. According to a strategist analyst from RBC, Michael Turner, the news about further economic development plans, as well as usual discussions concerning the monetary incentives amid releases of important statistics, supported the Australian dollar. That's all I have for now.
Thank you for the review of the currency market, Anna.
You're welcome, Olga. How did stock market behave?
On Friday, the U.S. stock market also demonstrated advance, heated by weak labor market expectations of further quantitative easing stimulating measures. Mining and steel companies were leading the growth in S&P 500 index group, which was triggered by talking about mergers, demand in China and raw materials prices increasing. The shares of Alpha Natural Resources climbed 17%. In addition, on Friday, the shares of Google crossed the line of $700 for the first time since December 2017. The shares added 1% daily. The close price was equal to $706.15. At the same time, the shares of Intel Corporation slid by 3.6%, when the largest producer of semiconductor IC downgraded the sales forecast for the third quarter of the current year. These were the main stock market trends of the last week.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
You are watching the weekly review of the Forex and stock market presented to you by InstaForex TV team.
With Olga Vitkovskaya
and Anna Kasatkina.
See you next week. Goodbye.
Goodbye.